and gentlemen. My band sounds like there's a lot of you out there. Well, here it is, 1976, and we're making our yearly visit to Boston. And as I told the people at the first show, we have the golden opportunity of spending 5 days in your town, this being the first event. So we're going to check you out a couple of times. And the process of checking you out will begin with Ray White on guitar. Patrick O'Hearn on bass. Terry Bozio on drums. Eddie Jobson on keyboards and violin. And the lovely Bianca on keyboards, vocals, and tambourine. And me, your old friend, Frenchie the Pooh. We're going to start this show off the same way we started the other show off. A song about your feet. You can bring the keyboards down the side fills a little bit. Yes, bring my vocal up on the side over here. Want to make sure we don't have any problems later in the show. We're in the dark, where all the fingers go. Under the water, where the sharp bubbles blow. In the morning, by the radio, through the balls throws in the suffocation. You ain't got no friends, and all the others are hatred. It's a life you've been leading, you gotta go up on tell the truth. Well, let me straighten you out about a place I know. I get your shoes and socks off, people, because it's right around the corner. Out through the night, from the whisper of peace, through the place where the kicker has to bury the losers. Out through the night, from the whisper of peace, through the place where the kicker has to bury the losers. All this disease, Roma Joseph, and well, they should. But us regular folks, you might wear a tennis shoe, or an occasional python boat, or this exquisite little inconvenience by the name of Stink Butt. You know, my heart on me was too tight. I couldn't get it off last night. We went by, not to lie. Finally got that sucker off and my girlfriend cried, you got stink foot, brother. He's stinking foot, foot's the hurts on my nose. Stink foot, iron, when we rinse it off, we use the cold. Well, here my little thing, the surface is happy, the surface is happy. Well, here he is again, and once again, as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, this dog does not have slippers in its mouth. Fido, why? Why do you treat me this way? I asked you for the slippers. You never bring me the slippers during this part of the song. You know that when you don't bring the slippers, I have to hurt you, Fido. I have to hurt you a lot. Literally translated, it means hurt me, Frank, hurt me, and hurt me some more. Very well then, Fido, here it comes. It's the big one. Yes, it's the big one. This is right in me. See, where does he get it tonight? Okay, Fido, in the medulla. In the managua.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's going for the big three in a row.
Work that poodle. looks like he's been... Poodle. The reason the poodle was a mistake was that originally he wanted to build a schnauzer, but he fucked up. When the schnauzer, which eventually became a poodle, was constructed, it was okay. It was a nice looking dog. It had hair, a lot of hair, all over its small, piquant, charming, canine-type body. As indicated by our poodle replica tonight. Now, as soon as God had made the first mistake, he made the second mistake. This mistake was called Man. And then he made the third mistake. It was called Woo-Man. Now, Woo-Man looked upon the poodle with lust in her heart. Checked that poodle out and said, I wonder what it would be like if this dog ate my pee-pee. And because they were blunt in those days. They were very blunt. So she looked at the dog, and she figured that the dog would be quite attractive if only it would get a sort of a mod haircut. Get the disco look and a couple of little bows on his hair. And of course, she would look a lot better if she had a small fur coat even during the summer, and perhaps some diamonds around her neck. But that comes later. So in order to modify the aforementioned dog, the woman devised an ingenious plan. She turned to the man and she said in these words, sucker, go get a job. And the man, because even then, man was chump. And he got up and he went out and he got a job. He figured that if he brought her the money, then he would get some action later. That's the way the woo man always works it. Anyway, it worked that time. He went out and he got a job, came back, gave her the money. She patted him on the head, dashed out the back door of the Garden of Eden, and went to the hardware store and picked up a pair of scissors and some zircon-encrusted tweezers. Came back and started whipping on the aforementioned dog in the manner that I will now describe you. Wait a minute.
Nice.
Work that poodle. Oh, she flipped on his back. Oh, she flipped on his tummy. Oh, she flipped all around his little pee-pee here. Flipped all little brown things. No front, okay. The buns, but no front. Then
She worked thoroughly on this muzzle area because that was the business end of the dog, even in those days. Would you believe that it's raining onto the stage? Sure is. Well, nothing but the finest here in Boston. Anyway, see this part here, folks? These succulent, enticing little black poodle lips. She cleaned up around there so she could see the little serrated edges. And she stuck the dog over on the side. And that's right! And then she went over and sat right on his snout. And believe it or not, from this impossible position, was able to look deep into the dog's eyes and say these words.
Let me see your thigh.
flies all green and buzzing in his dungeon of despair. Prisoners grumble and kiss their clothes. From a window hole 100 yards away is all they ever get to know. What's the regular life in the day? The snake's so bad, the storm's been choking. Green and green is drops in the room where the giant fire put the words. The torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture never stops. Sinister midget with a bucket and a mop where the blood goes down the drain. And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking. Green drops in the room where the giant fire put the words. Where the torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture. The torture. The torture never stops. A steaming pig in a chamber right here there. He eats the snouts and the trotters first. The loins and the groins is soon dispersed. His carving style is well rehearsed. He stands and shouts. All men be cursed. All men be cursed. All men be cursed. And disagree. Ha! No wonder. He's the best, of course, of all the world.
He's the best, of course, of all the world.
Some wrong been done, he done it first.
Some wrong been done, he done it first.
And he stinks so bad, his balls been choking. Green, green is drops in the night of the iron sausage.
Where the torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture. The torture. The torture never stops.
all green and buzzing. It is dungeon of despair. Who are all these people that is locked way down there? Are they crazy? Since the first it was created, but a dungeon just like a sin, it was not the locking of everything that's ever been. Look at me. We'll be right back.
setting up time you like. Don't you wanna go with a tiny auto horn?
Let the people see.
Let the people see.
Let the people see.
Bamboozled by love. Oh Lord, the shit done hit the fan.
Bang, bang, bang.
Bamboozled by love. Oh Lord, the shit done hit the fan again. And you know why the shit is hit the fan tonight, ladies and gentlemen?
Get home on Friday.
this song or they did after this song. First of all, you should give an enormous round of applause to Bianca for her wonderful job in that song. Thank you. She appreciates that. It's unfortunate the way our program is structured. We like to keep everything going like that. We can't give you a clean-cut ending so you can clap and let her know that she's enjoying it. But it's very important to her that she knows that your things are sticking up like that. But now we have something, a deviation from our normal pattern of events here. I don't know how we're going to get out of it once we get into it. This is a song. It's one of Terry's favorite songs because it sort of expresses his viewpoint on life. Terry, of course, you might have forgotten, is the person with the lipstick on playing the drums back here. The name of this song is I'm So Cute.
Sin leads to eternal damnation and fire.
burning fire. Hot burning fire. Hot burning fire. And screams of agony. Screams of agony. These things are motorcycles, tits, and beer. The name of this song is Chrissy Puke Twice. Was no moon inside. You know the stars ain't shining, cause the sky's too tight. I heard the scary wind, I seen it of the trees. There was a werewolf on the lawn inside of me. I'm mean and I'm bad, you know I ain't no sissy. Got a big titty girlie by the name Chrissy. Talking about remember my dear me. And this ride up the mountain, this bee is me. Feeling out of sight. We had 20 reds and a big old pile of weed. You know we drank some wine and then we LSD. Pressing you twice as drunk on my fight.
Burn, cause you know what I like.
She burned the lid on her tailpipe then and yelled,
Sherry!
Moved again. Beer. I said, give me some of that, what you sucking on? But there was no reply because she was gone. Where's those titties I love so well? And my goddamn beer is what I started to yell. Then I heard this noise like a crunchy twig. And up jumped the devil, raise your mouth to sing. Bet you don't hear the widow's feet. And then point your tail and like a sulfur ring. All right. I knew it was. He had some human flesh stuck underneath his bar. You know it looked to me like it was titty skin. I said, you son of a bitch, cause now I'm mad at him. But he just got out the floor and started cleaning his fang. So I shot him with my shooter and said, bang, bang, bang. Then the sucker just laughed and said, put it away. You know I ain't a holler. Now what you gonna say? You ate my pussy?
Yeah, titties and all.
Well, what about the beer?
I put a can in this trial.
Even her boots?
Now would I lie to you?
Shit, you must have been hungry.
Yeah, this is true.
Well, don't they pay you good? What you gonna do?
Well, you know, I can't complain when the checks come through.
Well, I want my pussy now, and I want my beer. You just puke it right back up. Do you hear?
Blow it out your ass, motorcycle man! I mean, I am the devil! Do you understand? Just what will you give me for your titties and beer? I suppose you notice this little contract here.
You're goddamn right, you a son of a whore. That's not the only reason I learned right for.
Oh, yeah.
Give me that contract, put your ass on the side. Cause I need a beer and it's titty squeezing time.
Listen, you can't fool me. You ain't that bad. You should have seen some of the souls that I had. Why, there was Milhouse Nixon and Agnew too. And both of those suckers was worse than you.
Well, let's make a deal if you think that's true.
Make a deal.
I mean, you're the devil. What you gonna do?
You wanna make a deal with me?
Yeah, I wanna make a deal with you. I'm not afraid of you.
You're supposed to be afraid.
I'm not afraid of it.
Wait a minute. You want to make a deal with me?
Listen, take my soul.
Take your soul?
Yeah, take my soul.
Nobody ever said that to me.
It's only because I like you so much. Just take my soul.
Wait a minute. Look. I'm going to reconsider.
You already got the souls from the guys in Black Sabbath. Take mine.
Man, now, wait a minute now. You come out here.
Take my soul, it's a mean little sucker. It's about 1,000 years old. Once you get it, you can't give it back. Gotta keep it forever, that's a natural fact. Take my soul. I want some tits, I want some beer. Good hockey here. Tits, beer, and hockey.
No! Don't sign it! Give me time to think! I mean, hold on, boy!
And then the devil puked, and I dumped my girl there. The titties pop, all around the world.
I got me three beers and a couple of down, and I'm gonna get rich, so that's what you drown.
And then she gave us the finger, it was rigid and stiff. That's when the devil, he farted, and she went right over the cliff.
Oh, that's the best I've ever been
on. Oh, I knew you'd enjoy that. You know the devil was mad. I took off to my bed. I said, I do declare. How did you get back there? I said, I do declare. How did you get back there? I said, I do declare. How did you get back there?
I
said, I do declare. How did you get back there?
I
said, I do declare. How did you get back there?
Graduates, the ones who made it, especially the ones that got out of Berkeley while there was still time.
Thank you. Tonight, ladies, here he is with his marginally visible violin, ready to whip one off for you. Give him your undivided attention. Take it away. Pizzo Cato. Pizzo Cato mit Ecoplexo. Thank you.
Thank you.
means you like it or you don't like it. Thank you.
mouth. He told me that he loved me, I believe what he said. He took me for a sucker boy. Oh, the next day I knew he had a boat on the door.
Thank you.
Christ.
Screen, you know what I mean?
could scream.
Bobby Little, Steven Tyler, too. Bobby Little, Steven Tyler, too.
Hey, you chicks sound real far out and groovy. Ever been to a holiday with? Magic fingers in the bed, wall-mounted TV screen. Bobby Hull's plugged into the bathroom wall for Michael.